How is it possible for Bucky to be so incredibly consistent in the late game when it's so chaotic?
I'm just clear, keeping height.
I got the body.
25 white on this kid. 25 white on the
staying ahead,
bro. I'm looking for frags. I'm looking for frags.
Yeah, frag out. Let's go. Get killed.
Yo, in zone right here. In zone on me.
Dead. Another one on me. Dead.
Can you harpoon? Can you harpoon?
Dead?
I have a harpoon. I'm harpooning.
I just fell.
Two on me, I died. You guys got this stuff.
Okay, Kanani, you gotta stay up.
Getting to the end game is hard in itself, but performing in end game, yo, that's a whole new beast to conquer. Arguably the most challenging part of every competitive Fortnite game, right? End game. It's made up of players smashing to smaller and smaller zones until, you know, one is declared the victor. You may be asking yourself this, like, where do I possibly begin to try and improve on my end game skills? Buncha Crunch Army, where you at? Your motivation guy is back, and today, I welcome you back to the final installment of our advanced series. Okay, so if you haven't watched the first three installments, guys, check them out in the description below. Today, we're going to be exploring everything that you need to know about dominating every endgame in competitive Fortnite. The fundamentals that we're going to be introducing in these series are complex and sometimes challenging to master. So make sure to check out our pro coaching service as well as our new VOD review system to get better quickly. Link can be found below. For the sake of separating mid and end game, all right, we're going to consider the beginning of the end game and half zone. Half and half refers to the fifth zone where half of the zone is in the circle and the other half is in the storm. Once you make it to half and half, the real work begins. So the first thing that you need to be looking at is the terrain around you and begin to anticipate the first moving zone. Ask yourself questions like, can zone play up a hill or off a mountain? Can moving zones play over water? Could I have to rotate into a congested part of the zone? All of these questions, guys, should be considered and answered once you are safely in zone. So by answering these questions early, you're gonna be able to anticipate every moving zone prior to your rotation, and in turn, you won't ever be caught off guard by any moving zone. Now that you have considered where each zone could pool, your next priority is picking a layer. All right, deciding which layer to play can be a very complex thing or a very simple task depending on what you're considering. So with that being said, here are the most important things to think about when picking a layer. All right, first, you have to consider your original question set. Like, if there is a chance that moving zones can play off or up natural height, you know, you're going to want to find an elevated mid-ground layer to occupy instead of low ground or even height in some cases. Next, you need to consider the congestion of layers. You want to pick a layer that will have very little to no occupants to give yourself the best chance to rotate uncontested. While rotating and moving zones, all right, you may have to switch layers multiple times to make sure you are continually occupying an uncongested layer. Finally, how many materials do you have? Like in competitive Fortnite, generally speaking, the lower you get to the ground level, the more congested the layers are. This means that you want to try and occupy as high a mid-ground layer as you can without being second height. If you get to second height, you have to either drop or contest for height. But you know, most of the time, you won't want to contest for height unless you have materials to just capitalize off of it. So generally, you should elect to drop. You know, we see a great example of this in this endgame with Bucky and Co. Bucky realized shortly after shockwaving that he was second height and immediately proceeded to drop. The zone then proceeds to play uphill. Okay, so he shockwaves again and ends up on natural height. So identifying when you are in need of a refresh can be very, very challenging. So head on over to ProGuys.com, man, where the best coaches are offered to help you guys with all aspects of competitive Fortnite. So throughout endgame, you're gonna need refreshes. Identifying when and where you can get those refreshes is the tricky part. As I discussed when picking a layer, a majority of players will occupy lower layers, which means that a lot of refreshes will be available in lower layers. One important part of properly getting refreshes is anticipating your need for a refresh. This means that you need to be both careful when you're going to need a refresh, as well as proactively looking for one on every rotation. So one commonly used trick is, you know, for you or, you know, one of your teammates to carry a harpoon to harpoon loot on the ground. So getting a refresh needs to be both calculated and coordinated. So when you're looking for a material refresh, all right, it needs to be during a time, you know, during which you are still going to be in a profitable position moving forward, giving yourself the best chance to stay alive and continually dominating. So in this clip, all right, we see Bucky's team with very low mass, so they elect to take a low ground layer and look for a refresh. As to be expected, this is a very congested layer, but as you can see, multiple refresh opportunities are available. Then they move off of low ground to an uncongested layer and begin to tarp all. Why? Continuing to look for a refresh. The final thing that we want to talk about today is inevitable situations. All right, endgame is very chaotic, man. And sometimes it seems like you can't get a single zone and are always max rotating. Okay, so as you're improving Fortnite, one important thing to understand is sometimes things happen, man. Especially sometimes that are completely like outside of your control and you're left in a terrible spot or even sent back into the pregame lobby. So making the most out of these situations can drastically increase your chances of making money each tournament. So these situations happen to everybody, and the way you respond is what's gonna make you a better player. All right, so let's go back to the first Bucky endgame. Here we go. He manages to defy all odds and somehow make it up to height after getting multiple refreshes and finds himself in a 1v3. He knocks one to Storm and another with his shotgun before losing the fight to the last person due to having no mats and low health. This is just one of those situations that Bucky literally did everything that he could, but still came up just short. Although he is upset, all right, he did everything he could possibly do, and he just moved on to the next game. All right, so now for the wonderful recap. Here we go. Firstly, after you make it to half and half zone, figure out where moving zones might play and begin to formulate a rotational plan going forward. Second, in moving zones, prioritize getting to an uncongested layer mid-ground. Third, calculate and coordinate material refreshes so you can just continue to dominate in-game and you won't die having no mats. And fourth, understand that there are inevitable situations and just make the most out of them. All right, guys, once again, it's your motivation guy. That's right, your friend, the one and only Keith Allen, man. I believe in you guys. I want to let you know that again. Once again, I am your number one fan, so you better not give up. I know a lot of things are going on in our lives, man, but continue to persevere and just make it through this, all right? Just make it through this because, listen, you're always getting better, like I always say. So I showed you guys today the most important things to consider if you want to dominate every endgame. Which one of these strategies do you guys think is the most important? Let me know in the comments. And if you like this series, if you want to see something similar to this in the future, if you guys enjoyed the video, drop a like and don't forget to sub. Bunch of crunch, army. Keep eating that bunch of crunch and let's get this going.